What is up, you guys? It's Violet Taylor here. Welcome back to Let's Catch a Vibe. Now, I hope everyone's feeling great, feeling amazing, feeling vibey. As you guys can see, tonight's item shop is for Sunday night, the 26th of February. Going to be taking us into the early morning of Sunday, the 27th of Feb. So, as you guys can see, we had the Flakes Power Pack introduced last night. Really, really cool. Definitely recommend grabbing this, guys. Also, definitely recommend checking out my Is It Not Worth It Thunder video on it and the TikTok video that I did on it. Moving us on to the rest of the items, we have the Lucha Bundle, we have the Dummy, no, not you, the skin, we have the Operation Black Tabby Bundle, we had the Venture Bundle, we have some really, really cool items in the daily store, but what we're going to get tonight in 3, 2, 1, let's go! Okay, we got some interesting things to start off the week with. We have the return of the Honorby Bundle, 6-item bundle, very, very cool bundle. Definitely recommend grabbing this bundle for sure, guys. I have already covered this in its own Is It Not Worth It bundle video, but nevertheless, definitely recommend grabbing this. Moving us on to the return of the Grimmore skin. Soul Reaper of the Near Future, part of the Forsaken set, first introduced in Chapter 3, Season 4. We have various styles for the skin. So we've got the default here, and then we have the alternate way. You can pretty much have her hood up. But moving us back to the default style, we also have a colour. We have a colour grade, which is the Grimoire to the Bone White. Jeez! And obviously, you can put her hood up in this style as well. Very, very cool. Literally introduced, literally Halloween just gone. So fairly newish. We have the Hollow Skull Backbling glowing with dread. You guys know me, I love my holographic and floating backblings. Moving us on to the harvesting tool, we have the Forsaken Strike. The latest in Reaper style. Again, looking very, very cool. Love the holographic pommel there. Part of the Forsaken set. Again, first introduced in the Marvel season. Moving us on to the return of the boy himself, but in Toon'd form, Toon'd Meowsles. Really, really cool skin. Definitely recommend grabbing this. The built-in emote and the lobby music do have music featuring Trippy Red, which is very, very cool. Moving us on to the third half of the featured store, we have the return of the Surf Witch. Curse the Beach with Your Dark Presence. Part of the Demon Beach set, first introduced in Chapter 2, Season 3. So we've got the default here, as you guys know. We then have the alternate, which is the Surf Demon version, which is really, really cool. I didn't know the fact that it swaps her glasses out for like T-shades. Very, very naughty, but I like it. Moving us away from this, we have the Backbling, which is the Star Power. You've got the makings of a real star. Part of the Demon Beach set. Now, the Backbling, as it says, is reactive. It animates with illumination, which is very, very cool. Moving us on to the harvesting tool, we have the Starstruck Axe. Show off your star power. Again, the harvesting tool is reactive like the Batbling. It animates with illuminations. Moving us on to the return of the Hajifat bundle. Nice little cool bundle. I love the fact that the Shadow Puppet Glider has an actual puppet show on there. And then it turns into like a giant lantern glider, which is very, very cool. I have already covered this in its own Is It Not Worth It bundle video as well. Nice little bundle. I would recommend grabbing the harvesting tool though, because you could use this for like the Kratos skin, especially the alternate style. Jeez. Moving us on to the return of the daily store. We have a bit more of an extended daily store today with 3 skins again. We got the return of a goat, the goatest of all time. Again, part of the goat simulator set, first introduced last season. Last chapter. Anyway, this gold is 1287. Moving us on to the return of the Versa skin, not to be crossed, not to be confused with the Neo Versa, because she is the blue version. So we've got the Versa skin, Mastermind for Hire, part of the Neo Chaser set, first introduced in OG season 9. She literally looks like, off the bat when you think about it, she literally looks like an Overwatch character. Anyway, can I just say, we like those, baby! Because she got those Neo cheeks. Again, I also admire like the kind of like PVC see-through plastic jacket she has on. Very, very cool. Anyway, moving us on to the Batbling, we have the Frenzy. Burn through the firewall. Now, just have a bit of animation as you guys can see there. Moving us on to the return of the Snorkelop skin. diving headfirst into the fight. First introduced in the OG Season 2. I'm very, very surprised that this hasn't become like a sweat skin. It's just got that kind of look to it. But nevertheless, really cool. Mirroring this under the return of a sweat item, we have the Star One. Everybody and their mother uses this as a sweat harvesting tool. I shit you not. When somebody downs you and they attack you with a harvesting tool and it's this one, you know they're a sweaty player. Anyway, moving us on, we have the Star Wand. Swing for the stars. Now, it does have a bit of a particle effect, if you guys can see at the back of the star. But again, really, really cool. It's just a shame it's a sweaty thing. Anyway, moving us on to the Chugger Chugger Chugger. You guys know we always usually get this when we have the return of two Meowsles. Just comes hand in hand. We have the Chugga Chugga. Your training begins now. Part of the Inkfill Gang set, first introduced in Chapter 2, Season 6. It is a synchronized emote, so you drive the train and invite other players to join in the train cars behind you. Moving us on to the last two items of the daily store, we have the Llama Bell. Clang, 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 clang. First introduced in OG Season 5. Jeez! Moving us on to the return of the Sasquatching Traversal emote. Put your best Bigfoot forward. First introduced in Chapter 2, Season 2. You already know that's my favourite season. Anyway, moving us on to the bottom half of the item shop now. We still have the Axion Sentinel Level Up Quest Pack. We still have the WooWare Bundle and the WooWare Gear Bundle. We also have these items that you can buy separately. We had the introduction last night of the Flex Power Pack that is still with us. Really recommend grabbing this, guys. It is a really, really cool skin. Moving us on to the return of the special offers where we have some videoing game inspired items. We've got Pac-Man's Bat Bling, the Pac-Brained emote, the Galaxian emote. Moving us on to the return of Captain America and the Bright Star Bundle. Really, really cool bundle now. Definitely recommend grabbing this before it does disappear. And then moving us on to the bottom now, we have the Most Wanted that is still with us. I believe you guys have until Tuesday to get all the Most Wanted quests done and to get these items as well. Some really, really cool items here, guys. Definitely recommend grabbing these. And then, yeah, guys, to finish us off, that was the end of the item shop with the special offers and bundles. But yeah, guys, nice little item shop to start us off the beginning of the week or the start of the week. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to smash the like button. If you didn't enjoy the video, let me know in the comments down below why you didn't like the video. Also, let me know not only what is your favorite skin from tonight's item shop or favorite item from tonight's item shop, which is your favorite bundle out of the ones we have returned. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you are new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're new and join Team Let's Catch a Vibe. Also, if you are new, please don't forget to switch the bell notification to get notified as soon as I upload. But more importantly, don't forget to stay vibey. And if you're in the woods, look out for Bigfoot. Peace.